Look at the brave adventurer who goes on this forgotten island.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Flotsam. I am Dynamite and today we'll be building a colony in the middle of the sea. Sounds familiar? Well, it kinda does. Now you probably remember the game called Bouncy that we played on the channel some time ago. That game was about building a colony, a gigantic raft in the middle of the sea, apparently after apocalypse. This is something similar in its concept, however, the difference, you probably already see the difference over here. Bouncy was actually quite serious. Flotsam is not so serious. This game is actually taking this as a joke, as an approach. So it's like a lot of more, let's say, family friendly per se, but also the actual gameplay is a bit different. And I'm really looking forward to this because I've had my eye on the game for like actually quite some time. The key has been supplied by the developer, so thank you very much for that. Really, really appreciate it. And the second thing is that please remember that this is the early access stage. So that means that there are subjects to change. The game is still in production, okay? So keep that thing in mind. But it's working. It's actually really fun.
Well, that's then. Grandpa's floats wiped away our village. Perhaps we should stop sticking out those loosest rocks and go explore.
Who needs land?
Those endless blue waves! That's all we need! The flooded waters are outside.
Let's polish the plastic into beautiful pearls!
If only we're out of fuel. How shall we name our new town? Flotsport. Okay, sounds actually nice. Start our adventure! So yeah, you start in a little... God knows what this thing is exactly. I would guess this is some type of like lighthouse. I don't know. But apparently they used to have like a village over here and something went really, really bad. And now the only thing remaining of said village is a lot of trash. So yeah, and also apparently there's land over here. Woo! What's this? Can I click it? Sailboat on a rock. Alright, and you can get a sail from this thing. A mast. Okay, some drifters try to make a town on the island. Bad idea. With all the garbage faults. A sailboat has been wrecked on the cliffs though. Perhaps we can make use of its mast. Oh, this is nice. I really like the animation though. And the art style is just... Oh man, you're gonna see when I'm gonna start to build something, okay? I've saved the gifs and trailers of this game so many times. It cracks me every single fucking time I say this shit. Right, so we have some camera controls, resources. Boyer marks. What's this? Markers are your tools of getting items out of the water. Placing them will send drifters to collect the objects in range of the marker. Swimming marker, fishing marker. A marker that can only be used on a fishing schools. Drifters with a fishing boat can fish there. Okay. So I'm guessing this thing. Yeah, alright. So I cannot get those things without those fishes without having a boat. Okay, I got some food. I got some water. There's some other resources. Wet wood. Dry wood, plastic waste, and metal scrap. Okay, that's self-explaining. And down here, apparently, we have the markers. Okay, so... Boiler markers. Ah, alright, so I got this thing. So build, you get this thing. This button over here, and the game actually gonna tell you how many resources are there. Alright, so... What do I need? Is this building? Yeah, build. Ah, perfect. Okay, so what's this? Walkway. Okay, so this is like a platform thingy. Small storage. Small house. Then we have drying rack. Woodworking sheet. Water production apparently. Distiller. Okay, this is a tool tip, like work in progress. What's this? Boats? Mooring point. A harbor where small boats are both crafted and moored. Okay. We have a salvaging boat. A boat used to salvage ocean garbage and scavenge islands. And a fishing boat. Alright, and this thing? Ah, sails. Okay, so apparently I need to get to the island over there to get this thing. So this is out of the question right off the bat. So what exactly I should try to focus on the drying rack? Good for drying wood and fish. Oh, okay, so you got wet wood and then you need to get the dry wood from this thing. Okay, so for this thing we need plastics. Alright, so let's try to look for plastics first. Game? Okay, this is dry wood. How many people do I have? 3, apparently, according to this. So let's put one marker here. And I'm gonna put another marker somewhere with plastics. There you go. And I think I can... Ah, you can actually order the guide to focus on specific resources. And what's this? So you can increase amount of people per marker. Alright.
Okay, boys, come on. Go. Here we go. Bon voyage, motherfuckers. Yes, as you can see, yeah, they collecting plastics on the fly, actually on the swim. Into a gigantic barrel they have attached to their backs. That's just great. How's this guy doing? Oh yeah, sure, he has no problems with collecting this thing. This is cool, you can actually see the ocean floor, look. That's really cool. This is actually really... I wonder, can I dive? There's like a wreckage over here. I wonder will be like later on a possibility to dive. That would be cool. Okay. So I got this. Oh, okay. So the construction is gonna be weird. Right, let's try to build this thing here. Do I have enough storage though? How much storage do I have? Apparently my storage capability is 100 at the moment and I got 57 items inside. So making a storage yard is basically requiring me to get more plastics. And I have achieved that thing just now. Okay, so let's build you on the opposite side. We're gonna try to collect as many resources that is humanly possible before I'm gonna actually try to do anything.
That's right, boy, I'll keep smacking that thing. Keep smacking with you, mighty smacker.
She's just throwing the trash on the water. Yeah, I'm literally building a floating trash dumpster thing. Okay, so what? Not now. What recipe? Dry wood. Oh, okay. So we have to select the thing. All right, I've selected dry wood. So if you could be so kind and actually get me some. Never mind. Wood have been delivered, boys. Okay, so we're gonna get dry wood out of that. I think I'm gonna actually get myself one more dryer. Just to speed up the things. We need more plastics. Yo, does anybody see it's like a Hollywood star around here? You know, we need some plastics. Much appreciated, that thing. Thank you. I like how they're stockpiling the resources. Of course, if a storm is gonna occur, this is gonna be completely safe. There's no fucking way that this thing is gonna go overboard. Nah, easy mode, man. What are you thinking? Alright, so we got the basic resources done. So now what I need for water, for example. Shut up, phone, I'm trying to build a colony that actually is not gonna drown to the middle of the sea. So for food, I need to get the boats. Okay, so for the boat, I need a rope. And apparently, I get ropes from the woodworking sheet. Drifters craft resources with a wood, like rope and firewood. Firewood? Let me guess, the firewood is probably needed for the distiller, right? Remove salt from seawater to generate fresh water. And that's for sure gonna require... firewood. Alright, so that means I have to expand this thing right now. What else is this? What's this? Small house. A home where the drifters... Oh, okay, so they can rest here. And I actually have to build a house. Okay, that sounds easy enough. We just need to get some dried wood. So the dried wood is a work in progress. So for now, let's try to worry about maybe getting some water. I need more plastics! So I'm gonna actually start to build like some houses around as well. Actually, you know what? This would be probably a better place to make the port. Because we have... storages over here, so maybe that's gonna be the thing. Actually, whatever, this is early access, so probably the boat won't survive the next patch anyway. Right, let's build a that's not a house! What the heck? You call that thing a house? I highly doubt that that's a house. It's just a floating bed attached to the rest of the construction. Oh yeah, pleasant dreams! Ever heard of a water bed? Ever heard of a bed on water? So the water distiller is like a gigantic plastic bottle with a fire pit underneath it. That sounds legit. Fresh water, okay. And you need fuel for that thing. Okay, so I need to build this thing on the opposite side. Just to increase the transport of resources. I kinda like when I can squeeze like a small storage thing over there to help out with movement around. That's gonna be probably like a good idea. But anyway, you build this thing, right? And apparently you need to make firewood out of dry wood here. And then that thing is put into the fresh water distiller maker thingy. And then you're gonna make water out of it. So far this is all like self-explaining. The only thing that worries me is that eventually, what the heck is that? Please don't kill me. So let's put it simple. I got a woodworking sheet over here. That's making me fuel at the moment. That's later on gonna be used at the distiller to make me water. So that's like one thing. Okay, you guys need to go to sleep. So nighty night. Now I need to worry about making some boats, because apparently food will become a problem very soon, so if I'm gonna extend this thing, okay, I need 16 plastics to build this thing. Can anybody be so kind and actually dive and bring me some plastics? I can't because I have a... I'm allergic to water. So since I got a rope from this thing, I can now build myself a parking slot for the boat. Can I build it here? Oh, like this. All right. So what I need for the boat? I need more plastics. Okay, I got some plastics over here, so I've ordered them immediately to gather it. And that's gonna basically solve my basic issues. So food, water, yeah, that's the basic ones. And also I need to make like one more bed for the other settler that I have around. So where can I squeeze this thing? Next to that thing. Yeah, sure. So you can not only just hear the waves underneath your bed, but you can also hear your neighbors snoring. That's a great idea. All right, can I get a boat now? I need more plastics. Yo, can somebody bring me plastics? Anybody? Please? Pretty please? Today, and I'll put all of the resources, I can finally build myself a fishing boat. So build a fishing boat over there, and I'm gonna change this drink rack to do with fishes. Okay, that's gonna progress. And what about the salvage boat? Okay, I need more plastics. So is there like any more plastics deposits around? I hope that by mistake I did not screw myself and just took all of the plastics. So not actually I won't be able to do anything else. Because that'll be really not hilarious. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, that's probably the thing. Okay, I need to salvage something. Plastics. Okay, we need to salvage something really quick. Because I cannot swim outside of the vicinity of this. Oh, I screwed myself. I just did it. What did I just thought to myself? Don't screw yourself. What did I did? I just screwed myself. Okay, maybe destroy the... salvage thing as well, I mean the storage yard. That's 8 plastics. And how much it costs to construct? It's 8 plastics. Good. And now with the boat, go! Fish! Anybody? Can use the fishing boat? Hello? Yo! Oh, see a volunteer? There he goes. Good thing you got a fucking flag. It's not like this thing is gonna help you either way, but fine. Fine, dude. Okay. And he's just fishing. Oh, that's so cute. Captain! Listen, only because you're swimming around on a few connected planks does not mean you're a captain, alright? Holy shit. For some unknown reason to me, I cannot destroy the small storage shed, so I have to destroy the... the bed instead. Hopefully that thing is gonna provide me with enough plastics to build myself a scavenging boat. Come on, guys! Destroy this thing already! It's really important for the survival of the colony. If you want to see tomorrow a new day, you better start working. No sense, start working. There's not enough houses.
Really?
Okay, good. You're gonna build the boat right away. So I see some plastics all the way over here. So send the plastic boy. Enlarge. Oh, sweet. 62 plastics. So with 62 plastics, I should be able to maintain like a heavy colony. Heavy? Healthy. That's the proper word. The healthy colony. Also, I don't know what this guy is looking for, but I really hope he's not hungry. Okay, just make me more water and everything is gonna be okay, okay. Look and behold, Hollywood, plastic delivery. Sweet. How many plastics do you have? 10. Can't say that's much, but should be enough for now. Can anybody unload this? Thanks, boys. Plastics! The brave adventurer of my little colony swims towards the plastic pile. Thank you for the plastics, boys. Much appreciated. Yep, all of this thing gets on the boat. And now we have to return back to the main colony. I kind of like wonder, can I go on the edge of this thing? Or maybe this is just like one map that I need to like gather as much resources that is humanly possible and then try to progress further. Maybe that's the case. I don't know. Well, there's like shitloads of resources around here. Like really a lot. There's this thing over here that we need to probably salvage. To maybe finish the mission, because this is like a limited space. Either this is for the tutorial purposes, or this is how the entire game looks like, that you have like a limited space and you have to just solve like a specific issue.
Maybe? I don't know. Just guessing.
I think it's actually time to build ourselves a mast. I've cleared most of the area anyway. So yeah, we got like a bit of food, we got a bit of water. I've built myself 2 scavenging boats, 1 fishing boat. All of my villagers have beds. Made like a small storage thingy over here for like faster movement. So I got a storage here for the firewood and then a drying rack for the wood alone. And now this guy, he should be able to actually bring me some resources. I wonder where he's gonna dock. He's gonna dock on the opposite side? I think he will. What the hell has happened here? Holy shit. Okay, you gonna get out? You do. That's cute. Look at the brave adventurer who goes on this forgotten island. There he goes. Across the log, I guess. And into the sailor boat on the rocks. I don't tell me you're gonna be able to bring everything on one go. Maybe. Just like 5 metal scraps remaining. I do wonder what other islands we'll be able to meet around, like as we're gonna be exploring. Looking forward to that thing, that's for sure. Scavenging complete. Right, and now my brave villager is going back to his little boat. So he has a sail, he has ropes, and he has some metal scraps over here. So that's great. And with that thing, I should be able to build myself like a momentum device of my own colony. Right. Safe sail, bye! Get back to the island, I mean to the colony in one piece, please. I kinda like need those resources that you have on board. All of those nasty resources going into the storehouse. Okay, I still got like big of a problem with water, that's for sure. Okay, navigation. Alright, we should have all of the resources necessary. Oh, can you unload the boat? Come on! Oh, never mind, you just unloaded. Okay, that's a bit of a problem. So let's build you. Okay, I know I'm supposed to build you here on this side, but that's kind of like impossible because I kind of screwed my boat. So let's build you here. Later on, I have to build this thing in a different place, that's for sure. Construction commencing. Come on. Come on, build it. Build it. Build it. I really need you to build this. Stop wasting my time and build this thing already. What the heck is this boat having? A seizure? Hope not. I'm not gonna build another one. I don't have resources for that. Water is constantly a problem. Like, if we're gonna move to new territories, we have to keep in mind that water is the biggest problem right now, at the very beginning of the game. Okay, sail is almost ready. Holy shit, look at this thing. Hell yeah! So now what? No, sissy, what? Camera controls, no. Okay, that's for research. I don't know what to do to get research points. Construction cost. Storage yard. Ooh! House. A farm for drifters. They can rest. Scrapsmith? So this is where you make screws and pipes, apparently? Plastic recycle. Plastic net. Okay, that's nice. Water containers. Ah, slowly generates a small amount of fresh water. This is exactly the thing we need. Distiller. Removes salt from seawater to generate fresh water. I'm guessing this is more efficient than the one I have. Fishing hut. Uses a net and a bite to catch fish deep below the town. Import. Rough seaweed. I wonder how the heck I'm supposed to get that thing. Fish kebab. Nice. And a food truck. The best food at your favorite truck stop. Serves cooked fish, mussels, and sushi. Nice! Still don't know how to get half of those resources, but okay. So how do I go? This? Wow. What's this? Fuel? Okay. Requires... Ah! Features. Villagers, abandoned town. Okay, so for this thing I just need the sail, and apparently to get to those places, I need to have an actual fuel. Okay, what's this? Leaking water tower features fresh water, oil, abandoned town. Okay, so I can travel here. Right, good to know. But that's gonna be the thing, ladies and gentlemen, that we're gonna try to do during the next episode, because for now, I'm gonna do this thing over here. It shows promises. This actually is exactly the thing I've watched on the trailers and on the GIFs. And it's really, really a pleasure to see those guys walking around and, like, you know, jumping into the water, salvaging resources and stuff like that. I hope that my colony is prepared for the future adventures, but that's gonna be the thing we're gonna try to do during the next episode. So thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed the episode. Please help us a lot. I'll see you all. And our next video.